Hi, horse people. Well, I tell people if somebody has equestrian in their name title, or you see a horse center that has equestrian, it automatically means it's run by anal women who think equestrian is so much more dignified than a horse stable or barn. Equestrian centers are just notorious for ignorant horse, majority of women, running these places who want to look good and ride around their little arenas. Most of them have no horse sense. And I mean, you can come here and go, you can't judge everybody. I've been to so many damn equestrian centers. There's 1,000, if not 1,000,000 videos of equestrian centers, and it's always horses being handled wrong and inappropriately. So this horse, according to the news media, escaped. Got out. It wasn't the equestrian center failed to secure it. It wasn't that they didn't have a stinking place. So I'm thinking this is where this center must dump their poop, or because it's concrete here. And then they have these plastic boards here. And what this horse did, I guarantee you, was walking, and he tried to get out of there and had a bunch of people come trying to catch him. And they forced and put pressure on him and made him jump in here. They're not saying that. Nobody seems to know how this horse got here, but we have handlers and women here who love it and who are caring for it. And if you listen to the meaty guy, he's saying all kind of crazy stuff. So let's go ahead and watch this video now that I set it up and got you in a frame, or pissed off all the little feminazis that'll come here complaining and crying. He doesn't like women. Well, you know what? Question, I want you to tell me how many men you see when they finally get this horse out around his horse. You're going to see all women. And you're going to see him leading a horse wrong and yanking and pulling, and nobody has any concept about pressure and release, giving this horse some space.
Well, we hope so. John Monroe says we hope tranquilize. Well, I don't know if tranquilize is, may not, maybe they want the horse to be awake and to be assisting. Maybe trying to hoist some dead weight out of it.
Normally, they don't want to tranquilize a horse, because then he can't support his own weight and it creates more problems than you have dead weight. They may give him a little bit of sedative if they call the vet, maybe, so he doesn't stress, try to kick, jump, and all that. But nobody's saying how long he was trapped and how he got there. I'm saying, I guarantee you, he got out and a bunch of freaking idiots came running over. Get him, trap, and hold your hands up. Don't let him go. And the next thing you know, he's freaking in the dumpster, and nobody knows how he got there.
Mean jokes here online, but no, it's an equestrian center. It looks like it could have just gotten spooked there. Anyway, the halter. Yes, it's wearing a halter.
Oh, great! It's wearing a halter. That's wonderful. So they're leaving halters on horses that are loose.
That's correct. Okay. How did the horse get in the dumpster? Yeah, we don't know. That is the big question. How did it?
I just told you.
Get there. I guess we'll have some questions answered on the Fox 11.
And nobody's going to admit that it was their fault, and it'll be a stupid horse, and it'll be the horse wouldn't listen, and the horse pulled away, and the horse spooked, and it'll be the horse's fault, and ain't no human's going to stand up and say, it was my fault. I'm saying it.
11 news at 5 o'clock. Maybe it's time to, let me see here. Okay. Let's see. Patrick, I'm going to put the microphone down.
Okay, this guy's just rambling, so he doesn't have any horse sense at all. You have a lot of people. 1, 2, look at all these people. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, and there's a woman over here, 26. So you have 26 people around this horse. I get it. Everybody wants to watch. At least these people are kind of keeping a little bit of distance. You got 3 people on top of the horse, 2 people smothering the horse up front, 1 woman here trying to take pictures, and 3 or 4 on this side. Now, these guys are actively working and putting blankets and doing a pretty good job. They all got their little helmets on. Why aren't the women wearing helmets, Rick? You always say they... Well, you know what? I don't know why they're not wearing helmets. I don't care if they're not wearing helmets. Hang on, how did I get this thing loose here? I shrunk my... hang on. All right, we're back. So, again, they're trying to get the hooks and snaps. They do a good job. They have large rescue or large animal rescue training. A lot of fire department go to it. You know, it's government. They got a lot of money. They got to spend it somehow. Let's go get some training. Well, Rickett saved it. Yeah, but you're training, you know, millions of firefighters across the land at millions and millions of dollars for maybe the off chance of one or twice some idiot lets their horse jump in a dumpster. But anyway, according to the news, they say they originally were going to try to get a helicopter in there and lift him out. And there wasn't enough room to get the helicopter in, so they couldn't do that. So now they're going to use a forklift.
And now you're seeing the response. Oh. I'm going to bring Bob DeCastro in, everybody. You know Bob.
Let me bump this forward. So obviously this takes time. I'm going to go ahead and move forward. I'm sure you can find it. It's about a 30-minute video here. So I'm going 5-second bumps. Long time. This woman wants to walk a dog by her. Are you serious? Really? In the middle of this horse is scared you're going to bring another predator or a dog? Rick, she didn't know and she just wanted to help. And all right, whatever. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Working on it. Supervisor, supervisor, supervisor. And supervisor over here. Oh, look, she loves the horse, Rick. She's hugging it. Yeah, well, if she loved it, she wouldn't let it jump in a stinking dumpster. I guarantee you these people put this horse in there. Somebody ran up here and tried to corner this horse. Horse thought the only way was out. He walked right on these things, and it fell straight through. Rick, you don't know that. You can't say that. You just... Oh, shut up, you big dummies. Crying all the time. Nothing else better to do than come to a video that you don't like and then cry about it. Horse supervisors at the bottom here with the little hats on. I'm assuming this is a little drone videotaping this. A lot of harnesses. I didn't see a vet give it a shot. You got this woman grabbing on this horse like this is helping. You got this woman around her neck like she's helping. I thought there was another woman on the other side. This guy's trying to get in and do some work, hook some harnesses. He moves in. This guy's got a hand on it now. Or is this the girl's hand? I don't know. More supervisors coming over. We gotta have a lot of money. Let's do some bump ups here. More supervisors, more people. This guy's coming over to, this must be his girlfriend or something. I want to get in the camera. Oh no, he's handing out water. By giving a horse water. No fire trucks. They got a big old ladder. Yeah, that's going to help. Yeah, we see the fire trucks. Get back to the horse. Good grief. Rick, the cameraman's trying to do a good job and you're just being... Be quiet. I don't think you say cameraman anymore. Somebody might get offended. Okay, one thing I would definitely do when this forklift comes in, I don't want to keep bumping it up here because it's taken. Oh, she wants a picture. She gives it so he can take a picture. Are you kidding me? In the middle of all this, you want a freaking picture? Rick, she wants to help. Yeah, okay, whatever. How do stereotypes get to become stereotypes? People just make them up because they're not true. That's how stereotypes start. None of them are true. People just make them up. Okay. A lot of harnesses. I don't know if this guy is supporting this horse's head by keeping it up. I don't know why he's doing that. Woman here holding him. Woman here petting him after she got her picture, of course. Now she's... She can take time to take a picture, but now it's important that I pet him. All right, let's bump it up. Where the hell's the forklift? Come on. I could sit around and crack on these people all day sitting around. Rick, you just don't. Be quiet. Ah, here comes the old forklift. Bum, 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 bum. And then the big brown shark came. Some of you guys will get that. Reference Eddie Murphy. Let's see. How many people are here? Good grief. Now we got freaking 100 people. Okay, so he should have, if he had been a horse person, the sooner he can lift this higher without next to the horse, the better. Horses don't like things moving ahead. Get this thing as high as it will go, then get it over the horse and lower it. These people aren't horse people, I know that, but that's what they should be doing. Moving in so close to the horse's head may cause him to rear and he'll hit his head. If it's maxed out at the very top and then you lower it, you're not so much likely to spook the horse, cause him to rear and jump backwards. Now, depending on how long he's been in there, he's probably tired. Maybe not. You got this woman patting on his head. Good grief, woman. That's really helping Rick. Look, she's patting on his head. She wasn't patting on him when she was getting a picture. Anyway, so they're getting a strap on here. Let's see what the stupid media guy's saying.
See some other comments you guys are saying out there. Looks like they're making good work here. So we got a pretty good shot here. They have this horse securely strapped now, and they're moving the forklift in a little bit closer. Some very heavy straps there, and
ooh, very heavy straps. Ooh, man, moving in a forklift, very heavy straps. Oh, look at that very heavy strap. That's probably a very heavy knot, too. Okay. All right, so, since the camera's moving in, I had to make my little box bigger. Yeah, now if I was doing this, I would probably put somebody who knew everything really talking to this guy and making sure he only listens to one person. I think this guy might be directing him. But you don't want the forklift doing things on his own or trying to help, because when you get this many people, you have to have one guy controlling it, or one guy will be pulling and pushing. And so they're lowering this slowly. This is probably the worst part. This is where I would have put a t-shirt and covered the horse's eyes. And I've done videos where I get both my horses that I can cover their face so they don't freak out in case I had to lead them out of a burning barn or something like that. This would be the time to cover the horse's eyes. He doesn't need to see this. He can hear things, but he doesn't need to see all this. So I would have had something over the horse's eyes personally. I think that would have helped calm down, less likely to cause him to rear and jump up. Again, when you get a horse that's kind of like dehydrated, he's stressed, he's been standing, jumping, he's fought, he's tried to get, here comes this woman. Look, let me see if I can get close. Look, I'll sneak in here like a predator. Like the horse ain't got enough going on that I've got freaking the Wicked Witch or the Barn Witch coming over here sneaking in. Let me sneak in and bend through these bushes. That way the horse won't see me and I won't be scary. Are you serious? Get out of there, woman, you big dummy. You're going to scare the horse. Ain't like he's got, look at him. I got to bend down like I'm stalking. See, women don't think. And it's not just women. Anybody don't know a horse, you don't think that you're acting very predatory here. It ain't bad enough this horse has all these people doing this with something over his head and a forklift. Now you got to come sneaking around the bushes like a freaking lion, going to jump out and make the horse more nervous. Rick, she was just trying to help and you're... Oh, man, I get so tired of you crybabies. We are women. We are strong. We can do anything a man... You can't talk about us. That hurts our feelings. All right, whatever. I haven't got a lot of hate lately from my He-Man, Women-Hater, Man-Hater, Women Club. So, this ought to bring them out. He blamed women, and they didn't do anything. And these women were trying to help, and he blamed them. And when they lead him off, he blamed them for not doing it right. He just doesn't like women. Okay, whatever. All right, getting the straps, a lot over the horse head. I'm going to bump it up a little bit. Looks like I got it strapped. Again, the guy who's coordinated this has to make sure everybody's out of the way in case the horse kicks, jumps. Nobody wants to be by the feet. And the forklift driver does a pretty good job because he lifts it, and I don't know if this because this guy told him to do it that way or if he did it that way. But he puts weight, and he lets the horse get used to the weight on the forklift. So I'm still bumping up. They're still checking straps. Bumping, bumping, bumping. It's a long time for this horse. I don't know where these two women are going off. Where are these two women going off to? They got their pictures. I guess they're leaving now. Why are you picking this stalker? Here, line woman back here in the bushes, peeking through. Look at her. Peeking through. I'll be a little line. I'll make the horse feel comfortable by acting like I'm stalking it, and I'm going to pounce out on its head when it's trapped. That'll help. What the hell? I'm telling you, if you go to any equestrian center, you see all these smart, wonderful women that know everything about horses and tell everybody what they do wrong. And they don't have a damn clue of pressure or release, prey animal, predators, how predators act, how prey react, fight or flight. They have no clue whatsoever about those concepts. It's all about my pretty bit, my pretty black boots, my pretty brown pants that are too tight, and my pretty little black saddle so I can look cool, and making my horse with tight reins. That's all it's about. Get my little pink ribbons on my walls, and then I'll keep my horse at a place called an equestrian center. And that way it'll make me sound more dignified, because I know much more as an equestrian than those stupid horse people, or horsemanship, or horse barn people. I'm an equestrian person. Ooh! Good grief! Come on, lift the damn horse! All right, did they lift it? I wasn't paying attention. I think I did lift it a little bit. Cracking on the damn woman. Let me bump it up. Oh yeah, so the horse is swinging. They're checking straps now. This is pretty good. I think they take way too long. You get this horse up, get him out, move, and get him on the ground. This is a lot of pressure. He's already stressed. Of course, probably when they're going through this school, they got somebody that's not even a horse person teaching this. And they've got, you know, they've read a few books, so they're just going by. They Google how to lift a horse, and then they start teaching it. Get the horse out and move him. So they've got him up, and they could get him out and move it. And what do? They stop and let him hang. And now they want to put straps on their feet. They tie the legs. Are you kidding me? Probably in some manual, it says make sure the legs horse secure to prevent them from running or kicking. So they stop and let the horse hang because they couldn't put the straps on before they lifted and they put the straps on. Absolutely useless waste of time. I don't know why they're doing this. Well, I do know why. They're training and they're following some book or manual. You don't want to leave a horse hanging any longer than you have to. You got him up. He's not rearing. Clear it. Get him back and get him on the damn ground. The hell? Ain't nobody there with no horse sense. Well, we'll just hang him there, admire our work, take pictures, get a photo moment, put little things on, then maybe we'll move him back. Get the damn horse on the ground. The longer he's up here, the more chance he shifts his weight, slides out, his back falls out, he falls on his butt, he hurts himself. Get the horse on the ground immediately. Any of you freaking horse rescue people that are watching this, that's a tip from somebody that understands horses. This is a dangerous situation for the horse. You want to get him on the ground. Forget the little leg protectors. And you'll notice when he goes on the ground, he does try to jump. Now what do? Let's leave him hanging and take off the stuff that we left him hanging to put on. Are you freaking kidding me? I couldn't believe it when I saw this. I'm like, dude, you left him hanging there to put the crap on. You prolong this to increase the likelihood of an accident. You move him 2 feet and lift him, and now you still leave him hanging, and now you want to take the straps off. Are you freaking kidding me? I guarantee you in some damn manual, it says anytime a horse is being moved, you should have the legs secured. So that's why they did it, even though it makes no damn sense in this situation. Rick, they saved the horse. Can't you just be happy about that? Yeah, I can be happy about it. I'm glad they saved the horse. Look at it. Here's the danger. This is what you didn't want to happen when a horse was in the air. You, the horse is on the ground. Now, why is the horse doing this? Most people probably don't understand it. Why do you think the horse jumped? He's finally figured out he's free. He's stressed. He tried to do it in here and he couldn't. And he got to the ground. He has all these people. He's a nervous wreck. What do horses do when they're scared and trapped? Their first response is flight. He tries to run. Very normal, very predictable. Oh, here comes the woman back. I gotta get my pets. This is the photo op woman, I think. And I think they should be there. If the horse was blindfolded, he probably wouldn't have done that. Because most horses don't run when they're blindfolded because they don't know where they're going. So I still think blindfolding would have been a much better option. I don't know why they didn't do it. A shirt, a t-shirt, somebody take a shirt off. It's easy to make a blindfold, a scarf. I think that would have helped. Now, if a horse has never had it done, he may give a reaction when you put it on. So you need to be ready for that. They stop. They get the horse's cinches off really well right now. But see, they're moving this. I don't think they need to be moving things. This is not a horse person. I don't want to cause this horse to freak out. Don't do more than I have to. All we need to do is get these straps off and walk this horse away. I would have probably walked the horse with the straps away from this danger. This forklift is danger if the horse rears or falls backwards, knocks somebody, somebody tries to grab it with a rope. This is a danger area. I would have probably walked the horse away from this before I took all this harness off. But they have procedure once the horse is on the ground, according to the checklist route. So the forklift goes forward now. He doesn't even know how to go back. Why are you messing with the horse? This is to get that damn thing out of the horse's head so he can't rear and hit his head and get away from him. There's nothing connected to this. This forklift driver either needs to move the hell out of the way or move the horse away. This is very lucky here. See, people will confuse lucky has good. And I always say that. A lot of horse people are lucky, and because they're lucky, they think they did good, and they do the same thing again. This was lucky this horse did not rear and hit his head. This forklift should have been gone as soon as it's not needed. The horse should have been walked away over to stalking woman, where a nice, clear, big area where she's got to get her damn camera out and all these other looky-loos filming and camming. The horse should have been moved away from this. Kind of like now. Rick, you were cracking on that woman. Look at the way she's pulling. See her hand up close. Nobody who knows a horse leads. Notice this born witch with the phone here, giving directions. Probably on a phone, got everybody on quick dial. There's a horse in the dumpster! Come check your horses! It could get hurt! Somebody let him out! Come out and check all your locks! I guarantee you, she's screaming at everybody. This woman's pulling this horse. This woman's pulling on this side. You don't lead a horse that way, people. This horse should be led with a lead rope, given some space so it can move freely. And people think, oh, well, Rick, it worked. She was there. This doesn't work. If this horse wants to rear, this woman is getting dragged, and this woman is getting knocked out and dragged. But Rick, that didn't happen. I know, that's because you're an idiot. You've never seen it happen, so you don't think it can happen. I'm telling you it happens. You don't lead a horse where you have to, your arms are on the halter and you're hanging on to halter. That is a horrible, unsafe, and dangerous way to lead a horse. And when you see people do that, you automatically know they don't have a damn bit of horse sense. But Rick, there ain't an equestrian center and all those women are smart. Okay, sure they are. Still hanging on to the halter. Leaning back, hanging on. This one's hanging on. You have two people, both being great rescuers, leading the horse to safety. Oh, it was me. I led the horse back to the barn and put up. Well, I wonder who let the barn out. Maybe you, one of you two dummies, are the one that let it out. That's why you're here now. Rick, you can't blame them. Woman. Rick, you don't know what you're talking about when you... Look, got 8, 9 women right here. All of them. I'll chase the horse. I'll get behind them. I'll help trail load. I know I went to Pirelli. I went to Clinton. I went to John Lyons. I'm a certified trainer. I'll lead. I'll grab his halter. I'll work next to him. I'll stand in front of him and watch. I'll sit over here and watch. Okay, whatever. I just make stuff up. Nothing I ever say. Oh, another woman back here. Woo! Another woman. Yay! Yay! All right, let's see what the guy's saying now.
Unharmed. I'm sure that they'll send a veterinarian there to do a quick checkup.
How many women we got? Hang on. One. There's a man. Woman, woman, woman. Woman, 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 woman. Maybe that's a man. Woman, woman, woman. Maybe man.
Make sure the horse is okay. And, you know, a good, happy story here.
It is a happy story. It shouldn't have happened. The humans caused it. Somebody let the horse out. Somebody didn't secure the horse. Somebody left a halter on a horse. Somebody chased the horse into that bucket. I guarantee, man, I'm telling you, that's what happened. And I know nobody wants to admit it, and they want to blame me for being mean, but I guarantee you, that's what freaking happened. And, you know, you put a ramp here for horses because people want to roll their little wheelbarrows and be able to dump their stuff in the canister, so it will make it easy for humans. Then when a horse gets out, there's no way for the horse to go. All right, we'll end that there. Hopefully you got something out of it. I know, I upset some poor, sensitive, rice paper feeling, strong, independent, equal women, but they'll get over it. Come on, put on your big girl panties and try not to cry all night and eat ice cream to drown your sorrow. Rick, you can't say women eat ice cream. That's not, whatever. All right, well, in that there, buddy, must tell your good boys.